Welcome to this small video series about emotional freedom, which is going to be three parts. In this first series, we want to talk about like the state that we are in, many of us, and this maybe also it's a state of the world, busy lives, going from one thing to the other without really being aware of where we are. I'm reminded of this quote from John Lennon. He says that life is what happens while we're busy making other plans for the future, and not really recognizing that life is already what is happening here and now.
Yes, and our motivation with this video series, of course, it comes from our training, our experience working with ourselves, with our clients. But sometimes when we are so busy and caught up, as you say, in this world, in achievement, in work, and yeah, our families, we don't have these reminders. We are not conditioned, we are not taught at school, at university, to learn about emotional awareness, to learn to work with our emotion, to learn to listen to our feelings. So we really decided to try, yeah, to inspire people to really connect with their feelings and probably maybe explain a little more why it's really important.
One teaching session I did where I had one woman who said, like, why should I feel my feelings? My habits of distracting myself actually works pretty well. I can at least distract myself from myself for periods, and it's better than nothing. So really, when you're in that state that she expressed, she didn't really came to the point yet where there was a motivation to look deeper. And I think many people are in that place where it somehow still works to be a little bit distracted, be a little bit busy, not really stopping for a moment to ask yourself, am I really doing what I'm supposed to do? Am I on the right track? Am I embracing this moment?
I connect from my own life, maybe, you know, eight years ago. It's normal, that's conditioning from school, from university, and when you are like in this fast career track and you're achieving things and you're busy, then you're feeling maybe, okay, I want to do something else, maybe my career is not so interesting. Then again, you're busy, maybe trying to run like side business or something else. Then again, you're busy because we are hobbies and we are passions, and then you're running after that, and then you have to meet your friends. So there's absolutely no time to really connect with yourself, and we've been conditioned to that. So it's really difficult, and I think nowadays we have more and more events, especially here in Denmark, where you can really go, yes, for meditation, yoga weekends, and a little more start working with yourself. But otherwise, it's if you have a 9-to-5 job, you have family, you have a house, you pay your loan, it's a lot of pressure. And it's not easy, but it's possible. That's what we are here today. It's still possible to find time for yourself. Because, like, again, I also had people like, why I'm okay with my life, why should I go and feel my feelings? Yes, I had some sad days, I have some sad moments. Maybe when I go to the bar and drink a glass of whiskey or wherever it is. And when, again, I'm in this busy, why should I do that? So if you're experiencing something in your life that doesn't fully, you know, is aligned with you, or you feel like maybe it's your career, maybe it's your purpose, maybe it's your relationship, maybe it's your awareness yourself, maybe you're not happy with the way you're presented to the world. So by going deeper in your feelings, by discovering what you really feel, what you really want, you can also change the external situation. So just only external things change when internal things change. So yes, this journey is not easy. We can say it's not easy by any means. It's not easy. And if someone else is like, you know, tells you it's fast track and you will not feel pain, it's not true. Yes, we have to go where, and you know, just whatever happened in our life, and to embrace it and be present, loving ourselves. And when internal things change, external things change, because I'm mostly working with people who want to change their career and find their purpose. And it's not just like figuring it out somehow in your mind what's your purpose. It takes a lot of inner work. And with each step, I mean, how much freedom, how much expansion you can feel in yourself, in your relationship, in your work, it's simply priceless. So that's my motivation to do that in our work and connect deeper.
We divide feelings up, positive, negative, and the positive ones is the ones that most people pursue. We want to feel good, we want to feel love and happiness and laughter and joy, and sort of indulge ourselves in these feelings. But once the more sticky, nasty feelings that we've like described as the negative ones, when they start showing up, we usually want to run away.